Good morning, Lancaster Catholic.
I'm Michelle Lee.
And I'm Jamie Ely.
Today is Friday, October 25th, B-Day, and here's what you need to know.
Today's lunch is pierogies, steamed broccoli, breadsticks, and fruit.
If you're planning being a member of the Crusader swim team this winter, stop by the athletic office to pick up information forms.
Link leaders, please check your email for a message from Mrs. Fink.
If you're one of those courageous students to donate your blood, why not roll up your sleeve for our school's annual blood drive? It will be held on Tuesday, November 5th. Consent forms are due next Friday.
For all juniors and seniors, the Conestoga Valley High School College Fair is coming up soon. It's Monday, November 4th. You can get a list of colleges either in your homeroom or in the counseling office.
Monday morning, more college reps will be here. American University at 10:15, St. Joseph's at 11, and Widener at 11:40. While we're talking about college, we all know that it can be really expensive. But Natalie Knox found that some colleges and universities are trying to cut the cost for students.
The future is digital, so more and more schools are ditching textbooks, and that means big savings for college students. Local colleges like Temple University and Franklin and Marshall College are starting the process of converting to e-books to try to lower student debt. Last April, F&M's student government asked the faculty to address the high cost of textbooks that can exceed $1,000 per year. To initiate the switch, F&M handed out its first ever textbook affordability awards to faculty who best used open resources, and some have even begun finding alternatives for printed texts. I'm Natalie Knox.
Hey seniors, your class picture is Monday, November 4th during First Crusader period. Please be in winter uniform and bring a school sweater if you have one.
If you're looking for a good meal and to support a good cause, stop by Mod Pizza on November 7th until 9 p.m. for the Mini-Thon fundraiser. Mention LCHS and Mod will donate 20% of the profits to Mini-Thon.
The Varsity Club will be holding a casual dress-down day for Veterans Day on Friday, November 8th. You can simply pay $3 in homeroom for the dress-down. Remember, the theme is Sea of Blue.
And now for a news brief. A new convenience store may come to Lancaster County. Rutter's is planning a store in Manheim Township at the site of the former Stouffer's of Kissel Hill and Roseville Tavern and Grill. The Township Zoning Hearing Board holds a hearing November 6th to decide if Rutter's will be expanding to Township.
Climate change is a hot topic these days. Now one of the biggest companies in the world is trying to do its share to deal with it. Matt Flynn has the story.
Shopping giant Amazon is vowing to reduce damage to the planet by cutting its use of fossil fuels. How would a company that ships more than 10 billion items a year using planes and trucks do that? Simple. By making the switch to electric. Amazon has already ordered 100,000 electric vans. CEO Jeff Bezos says he wants all of his company's energy use to come from renewable energy sources by 2030. Amazon emitted 44.4 million tons of carbon dioxide just last year alone. That's the pollution rate of some small nations. You can expect to get deliveries to your doorstep with these vans by the end of 2021. I'm Matt Flynn.
The Washington Nationals are making history. The team is in the World Series for the first time in club history. It's also the first time since 1933 that a team from the nation's capital made it to the championship series. On top of that, Nationals first baseman Ryan Zimmerman hit the club's first ever World Series home run in his first at-bat. The Nationals are ahead of the Houston Astros by 2 games in their effort to return the pennant to D.C., Game 3 is in Washington tonight.
The Trump impeachment hearings got chaotic on Capitol Hill. A group of House Republicans tried to barge into the Democrats' closed-door hearings, saying it was unfair to be excluded. Laura Cooper, the Defense Department official who deals with Ukraine, had to wait 5 hours to testify. Earlier, William Taylor, U.S. diplomat to Ukraine, told lawmakers that he grew increasingly alarmed about U.S. officials trying to pressure Ukraine into investigating Trump's political rivals. The impeachment process appears to be on a roll.
Speaking of being on a roll, the Crusader football team looks to add another win tonight as they face Pequay Valley at home. This is the last regular game of the season, so show up and be loud, Crusaders. Kickoff is at 7.
And if you have a birthday today, you share it with singer-songwriter Katy Perry. Some of her hit songs are Roar, Dark Horse, Teenage Dream, and E.T. She turns 34 today.
Have a great day, Crusaders.